My name is Stanislaw Robert Liberto with AV Ultra, and today we're going to be taking a look at replicators in Apple Motion. In this lesson, we're going to be talking about what is a replicator, how it's different than emitters, how to make them and work with them, and we're also going to be creating a background using replicator shapes, and then finally, we're going to be taking a look at the sequence replicator behavior. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to go ahead and just take my Bezier tool here, and I'm just going to make a line. So I'm going to zoom this out just a little bit here, and I'm going to choose that tool and just draw a solid line across. And I'm just going to make sure that that's at the beginning of my timeline. And now that I have this line, let's talk about our replicator. To make a replicator, I just want to choose whatever I want to replicate. In this case, I want to replicate my Bezier line. To actually turn this into a replicator, I can come up to my replicate tab in the top right corner, or I can hit the shortcut key of L. As soon as I do that, two things happen. If you remember my lesson from emitters, the way that the emitter works is as soon as you create that, it will turn off the source layer and then turn that into a cell for that emitter. In our case, since we've created a replicator, that is referencing that original Bezier as our cell, and we've created a replicator layer. The main difference between a replicator and an emitter is that an emitter will continuously emit more of these particles across time, where a replicator doesn't do that. It just makes static copies of these since they're individual images. If this was a movie or, let's say, a video that you wanted replicated, then those would be replicated through here too. So let's take a look and see exactly what has been created through this replicator. So you can see that I'm dragging out this square that I have. And if I go to my replicator layer and I view my inspector, you'll notice that I have my replicator controls. Underneath that, I have my cell controls. My cell controls are referencing this individual cell. So if I've clicked on this cell here, you'll notice that I have just these controls. Let's go back to our replicator and take a look at this. By default, it will create a rectangular replicator shape. We also have our arrangement. We can set it to outline, which means it is only placing these replicated points on the outline of this particular rectangle, or we can set it to tile fill, which is what we've had before. And then lastly, we can hit to random fill. So you can see these different X's are where it's being replicated from. Currently, right now, there are 5 points being replicated, but I can crank that up. And if I change this back to tile fill, you'll notice that I have columns and rows. Now that we're in our tile fill, we want to go ahead and we just want to change these rows to 1. If I change this number to, let's say, 20, you can see that I have 20 individual copies of that one replicated line. You'll notice that I have these handles that lets me rearrange this, and this is effectively changing my size here. So you'll notice I have a height and a width that lets me specify this size. Now that we have our replicator set up, let's take a look at our cell control. Our cell control lets us manage the individual cells that we have in our replicator. Since we have 1 right now, that's all we're gonna be working with. If I change the angle, this is going to change the start angle of my replicator. If I change this to 0, and I go to my angle end, this is going to offset throughout my replication. Now that I have my angle end set to negative 30 degrees, what this means is because my origin here is set to the center, the center is going to be at 0 degrees from my start angle, and my angle end, which is the end of my replication, is going to be negative 30 degrees. I can also set an angle randomness. And what this is going to do is set a randomized angle for each of my replications. So this is going to be based on both of these numbers. So if this is set to 0, each one is now going to be a random 194 degrees. I also have an additive blend. An additive blend is only going to work if these were colored. So right now, because they're not colored, we're not seeing any changes. So let's come back to that one. Underneath that, we have our color mode. What our color mode will do is actually let us colorize our individual replicants. So I can go ahead and pick a color, let's say red, or I can colorize this over a pattern. And so what this will do is from one point to the end point, it will colorize them across the entire replication. So currently, it's coming from the center on its way out again. If I change this origin, by the way, from, let's say, center to left, now that color is going to transfer from green to this blue color as it's moving across there. In fact, if I add another color by just clicking in here, and let's make this one purple, now we have our color moving from green to purple to blue across this gradient. Lastly, we have pick from color range. What this will do is it will pick a random color across this range to colorize each of our different replicants. If we move further down here, we have our scale. And just like our angle, we have our scale start, and then we have our scale end. So we can have our original one start at say 0 or even 5%, and we can have that traverse across to 800%. Now, why isn't that 800% of the original? Is because it's exponential based on the first scale. So if this went up to 50, now you'll notice that each of them are getting much thicker. So it's exponential based on the original value. Because I have that additive blend mode on, you can see as they're overlapping that it is adding those two colors together. So if I turn that off, you'll see that they're just the colors of their individual values. I'm gonna change these back to 100 and let's move down. We also have our scale randomness. So our scale randomness is going to assign a random scale value, again, based on what our original scale is. So if this was set to 200% and our scale randomness is say 1,000, it's going to range from this 197 up or down 1,027%. We also have our random seed down here. So if I'm clicking on my random seed, you'll notice that it is changing our scale based on these different numbers. So again, let's go ahead and make this 100%, and I'm gonna change the scale randomness down to 0. Let's also go ahead and just change this to colorize, and we're gonna make this red right now. I'm gonna spread this out, and now that we have this, let's go ahead and take this replicator, and I'm gonna go to my properties, and I'm gonna change the blend mode to an overlay. And now I have a quick and easy background for my different videos. In fact, if I wanted to, I could even drop this opacity down and make it a little bit more subtle. Now let's go ahead and make something just a little bit more complex. I'm just gonna create a new group, and I'm gonna grab my circle. We're just gonna draw a series of 4 circles. In fact, there's my one circle, I'm going to duplicate it. We're going to move this guy over here, and we're going to make this one a slightly different color. I'm going to take both of those, duplicate them, move them down, and let's make each of those a different color as well. So now that I have my group, I'm going to go ahead and collapse that. I'm just going to name this base, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to replicate that. And now that I have my replicator, we can specify our replication. So I'm just going to keep this as tile fill. I'm gonna change the color mode to over pattern, and we're gonna change this pattern here a little bit. The first thing I'm gonna do is change my colors. Now that I've changed the color, I also wanna change the origin. So I'm gonna go from the top this time. So that's gonna color its way down. In fact, you know, also what I wanna do is I want this to be fairly translucent. So I'm gonna come up to my same color bar, and I'm gonna adjust my opacity stop. So we have our color stops down here, and on top we have our opacity stops. So I can set this guy to, let's say, 20%. And I'm gonna set another one over here to say 10%. So now that I've got my opacity set, I'm also gonna go ahead and I'm gonna change that. We're gonna change the blend mode to screen. And this is just gonna let the color in the background show up a little bit. I want this to fill my screen going from largest to smallest. So we're gonna come down to our scale end and make that quite a bit smaller. You'll notice though what's happening with my replicators is that they're kind of scooting over to the side. And the reason why they're not scaling proportionately from the center has to do with my original anchor point. So if I turn off my replicator right now and I turn on just my base, you'll notice that my anchor point is sitting outside of the 4 of these. So if I wanted to, I can go into my anchor point, and we're just gonna set this towards the center. So now if I turn on my replicator and I turn this guy off, you'll notice that they're scaling proportionally all the way down. To get back into my replicator settings, I'm just gonna change this to adjust item. And here I can specify exactly where I want this. I want this right down the center, and I'm gonna want a few more of these. So I'm gonna set a few more columns and a few more rows. So that's another way that we can create another background very, very quickly in Apple Motion. Let's take a look at creating a replicator from a replicator. So what do I mean by that? Well, I'm gonna go back and I'm just gonna draw another shape. So we've got just our Bezier here, and I'm just going to make that as centered as possible. And I'm going to turn off the fill mode, and we just want that out. And what I'm going to do with this guy now is, now that we have this Bezier, I'm going to replicate him, and I'm just going to change him to a line. And so now he's just going to be repeated across here. So now I've got my replication right here, and we're going to colorize this one, and we're just going to make him, let's say, dark purple. So now I've got my original replicator here. We're going to call this one replicator one, and I'm going to move him to the top of my section here. Now that I've got that, I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to take this replicator, and I'm going to replicate him again. So effectively, what I'm doing is I'm making a replicator of a replicator. Here is our original that's been replicated across, and now I'm taking that whole copy and copying it again. This time again, I'm gonna choose a line, and I'm gonna go to my adjust item and just pull him down, and we're gonna make him pretty close. Now that I've got this replicator here, I'm gonna go to its opacity gradient, and I'm gonna change this from 100% opaque down quite a bit. So what this is doing is that from the top to the bottom, it is going from 100% opacity to 20% opacity. In fact, what we can do is we can actually colorize this over a pattern now. So now we're placing a secondary color on top of the original one. So if I choose this and I make this, let's say, white, that's going to be that original purple. And I go ahead and I make this one maybe a little bit more red. Now that's moving from that purple all the way down to that red across here. One last time, I'm gonna take this replicator and replicate it again. And one more time, I'm gonna change this into a line and move this all the way down. So now effectively, I've created this repeating pattern that is based on several different patterns. And I can choose more points. So if I really wanna bump this up quite a bit, we can go ahead and scale this down. And you'll notice what's happening is we're losing some of this original one. And that's okay. We can come to our original replicator here and say we want more points. And so I can spread this out to say 10, and we can change that. So effectively, we can add more points whenever and wherever we need them. So now I can move this across here, and we can have that moving all the way across and add some more points. And now we have a scaled tessellated background moving all the way down here. The last thing I want to talk about here is the sequence replicator, which again is a very powerful function that is in Apple Motion. So now that I have a single square here, we're also going to replicate this. And this time let's choose a different mode. We have our point, which is just a single point, which doesn't really do anything for us. We have our line, which we saw earlier, that lets us replicate across a line. We have our rectangle, which we've already looked at. Our circle lets us replicate across a circle pattern. And again, we have our tile or our outline, and our random fill, which will put it in or around our circle. We have our burst, which does this kind of three-pronged approach. What's interesting about this, though, in our burst is we can choose how many points per arm, how many numbers of arms. So in this case, we can have, let's say, 4. And if I scale this down, we can take a look and see what that's doing. Our radius, we can pull down quite a bit. We also have our spiral, which is very similar to our burst, but this lets us specify how much of a twist we want. So for example, I can really twist this up, pull the radius down quite a bit, and you can see these kinds of patterns that we can create here. I can also adjust this offset, which really changes the shape of those twists. We also have a wave, which lets us change a wave. And we also have something called geometry and image, and we're gonna skip over those for this lesson. For right now, I'm gonna go back to my rectangle, and I'm gonna change this to tile fill. And I wanna make sure that my scale is at 100 again. We just wanna fill this canvas. So I might go ahead and actually change the scale just a little bit to fill that up. So now that we have this, what we wanna do is we wanna change each of these individual items across time. So if I go into my library, and if I go under behaviors, under replicator, we have a sequence replicator. And if I drag that onto my replicator and I hit play, you'll notice nothing happens right away. If I take a look at my window up here though, my preview window of whatever I'm gonna be putting on, it will automatically animate different parameters sequentially through replicated objects. So that's really interesting. So let's go into our inspector, and you'll notice I have my sequence replicator. We have our parameter of what we actually want to sequence. We're gonna change our opacity to 0%, and we're gonna change our scale to 0%. we're going to add one more, which is going to be a color. If we come down to our sequence control, we can see what exactly it's going to do. If I play this back right now, you can see what's happening is across the behavior timeline, we are actually going from 100% scale to zero. We're also going from 100% opacity to zero. And we're changing, and we're also changing from that white color to that blue color. So that's what that means here is this is changing to these different parameters. If we want to change from those different parameters, what that is going to do is it is going to change from blue to white. It is going to change from zero to 100% and a zero scale to 100%. You'll notice that we also have our unit size, which could be object or all, which means all of them are going to come in at once. We also have custom, which lets me specify the start and end. So this just gives me a little bit more control. Maybe I just want these outer. And what's great about this sequence replicator is I can change the timing of it very quickly, and I can change the parameters of it. So for example, maybe I don't necessarily want this to be white. I want the color mode to be colorized, and I'm gonna go ahead and make this red. So now this is going to be first starting off at that blue and then moving into that red. Perhaps I don't want 100% opacity. I just want that down to maybe say 30 or 40%. So if I go back into my sequence replicator, I'm just gonna change this back from custom to object. If I go into my replicator, the way that this is animating through this sequence is dependent on how the origin is set up. So for example, if I set this to upper left, now it's going to replicate from this top left all the way down to the bottom. We can also specify by row and by column. So now that we understand replicators, let's make a little something out of it. I put together this quick little animation here that has just a couple layers. It has a single text layer of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we also have a replicator layer based on a single rectangle. So you can see over time, this just kind of builds in. And we've got some nice little 3D-ness that's happening to this as well. So let's go ahead and put this together. So first things first, I've just drawn out this rectangle here. And what I'm going to do is hit replicate. Again, by default, it's going to choose rectangle, and I'm going to come back to that in a minute, but I want to change the color mode to over pattern. And if I go to my color gradient, I have this nice little drop down that lets me pick my different gradients. Now, to get that same one that we had before, I'm going to pick rainbow. And you can see we have our red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple. And I'm going to go over to my shape, and I'm just going to pick line again. I'm going to adjust my item so it fills my canvas. And I'm also going to go ahead and go into my library. And I have something called extrude under my filters. And I'm just gonna place that right on my replicator as well. I'm gonna go into my replicator and sequence replicator. And I'm gonna drag that right onto my replicator. I'm going to trim back how long that's gonna take. I want it to take about 45 frames. We'll go into the inspector and I want to change the position. Now that I've got my position, I want to move from a certain area to this position. So I'm going to go to the beginning of my sequence replicator, and I'm just going to drag this up until it is no longer in my canvas. So now if I come back to my canvas, you'll notice that that is building in one at a time. So far, so good. Now I'm going to go to my text layer, and my text isn't a replicant. This is clearly 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I don't necessarily need to go into my replicator to sequence my text. All I have to do is go under my text animation, sequence text, and drag that onto my text layer. So now that I have my sequence text, what I want to do is I want to move to this position from up on top here. So if I just grab this, drag this up here, and I want to trim back my sequence text so it lines up with this here. You'll notice that right now, it's going in the opposite direction. Well, that's okay, because I want to change the sequencing from to from. And so now across time, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So you can see that our text sequence works very similar to our sequence replicator. We're just changing our different parameters and then adjusting them over time. So that is a quick way on getting started with replicators. There's a lot more that you can do with replicators, and we're going to go deeper into replicators in a further lesson, but I just want to give you enough to get started creating things with replicators, creating backgrounds, and animating them as fast as possible. Again, my name is Stanislaw Robert Liberta with AV Ultra. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you next time.